Hi, I'm Alex, and I'm here to talk to you about using item groups in Shopping Actions. While browsing on Shopping Actions, shoppers are able to choose between different variations of the same product before making their purchase. In this video, you will learn how to set up and use the item group ID attribute and other variant attributes to group different product variations. To start, a variant attribute is used to help differentiate items of different sizes, colors, or patterns from one another. A Google t-shirt, for instance, comes in three different sizes: small, medium, and large. The variant attribute is its size. For your own inventory, you can choose from a large set of variants. Some common variant attributes are color, format, material, and size. Let's jump into a quick demo showing how to set up an item group and apply a variant attribute. First, you'll want to log into your Merchant Center account. Click on Products, and then Feeds. Select the feed you'd like to edit, and click on the three-dot menu to either access or download the file. To save time, we have already populated the required attributes for our products. We will only focus on the item group ID and the size attribute. Here's a pro tip. When creating an item group ID, it is helpful to name it based on the products you're grouping together. For this example, we are grouping together t-shirts, so we will use Google t-shirt as the item group ID. Now that all the shirts are grouped together, let's enter the different sizes: small, medium, and large. Did you know? You can add as many variant attributes as you need to help differentiate your products. Now that we have all our sizes, let's go back to Merchant Center. Click Fetch Now to save and review your changes. Make sure to provide adequate variant attributes so shoppers can find your products on Shopping Actions. Missing, duplicate, or inconsistent variants will lead to item disapprovals. Here's another pro tip. Only use item groups for the same type of products, like t-shirts. Item groups are not intended to group together products that complement each other, even though this Google cap would look good with these shirts. And that's it. That's how you configure item groups in your feed for Shopping Actions. Thanks for watching. Check out the links in the description below to learn more in our Help Center.